What's going on, Pixel Hackers? Christian Novosich from Pixel Feed here. In this video, we're going to talk about how to test creative with Facebook ads using dynamic ads. But before we get started, make sure to smash that like button, subscribe to the channel, and let's dive right in. Dynamic creative ads is actually one of the best ways to get your brand new Facebook ad account started. Or if you already have an established Facebook ad account and you're looking to scale, but you have tons and tons of creatives, meaning images and videos and different copy and all that, and you just want to figure out which one's the best right away without having to create, you know, a creative stack with 50 different ad sets and run it for days and days on end just to figure out which one works the best, dynamic testing is the best way to go. So what is dynamic testing? When you go into the ad set level, it says it right here, dynamic creative. It's basically providing creative elements such as images and headlines, and it will automatically generate combinations optimized for your audience. Variations may include different formats or templates based on one or more elements. So what I'm going to do in this video is I'm going to show you how to set that up and how to scale it once you figure out which one is the winning combination for your ads. So basically, the first thing you got to do is you set up your campaign. And as you guys can see, I already have an ad set running here. So I'm going to use this as an example. But basically, what you do is you create a campaign the same way you always do. You go to campaigns, create your campaign. And when you get to the ad set level, you start choosing all the elements that you want to choose for your ad set, meaning, you know, your interest, your 7-day click or 1-day click. And then make sure this switch is flipped on here. So after you choose everything here, your targeting and all that good stuff, what you're going to do is you're going to move into the ad level. Once we move into the ad level, you're going to see that Facebook, it's going to give you the option of uploading multiple types of media and multiple types of headlines and descriptions and you know, call to actions, right? So depending on your budget, that's what's going to dictate how many of these images and videos you should be testing at the same time. You know, it's really up to you. Basically, the more money you spend, the quicker you're going to get back the data, and you're going to figure out which one's your creative combination in order for you to scale. So when you get right here to the ad level, make sure you choose single image or video, right? And what you're going to do is you're going to go here to the ad creative, and you're going to start uploading those images and videos. And again, the more you spend, the more data you're gonna get back quicker. So like I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 different images and videos combination here on this particular ad set, but this one's spending $70 a day. And I'm letting it run for, you know, a couple of weeks just to see, to get real data back. But if you're only spending $10, $25, I probably wouldn't do more than 3, okay? So you upload all your media here, and the next step, you can choose to optimize creative for each person or not. Basically, what this does is, depending on the what phone or what device people are using, Facebook is going to try to optimize to show that in a better way. So basically, if your video is not formatted the right way, it will take up the whole screen or not. This is up to you if you want to leave it on or off. I have noticed that sometimes if you leave it on, it's going to use your description as your headline. So make sure you keep an eye on that. So I'm testing right now, so it's on for now. The next thing that you're going to do here is you're going to input your text, your ad copy, your primary text. All right, that's the paragraph that you see on the ads. I don't like to do more than 3. This is already proven primary text for me, so I know both of these are winning combinations, so I'm only using 2. But I mean, you can add 5 if you want to. Again, you gotta remember, the more stuff you add to your dynamic creative, the longer you have to test it. You can't just give it 1 or 2 or 3 days if you're spending $10 or $25 a day. That's just not enough for Facebook to cycle through and make the best use of those signals. Again, with headlines, you choose as many as you want based on your budget. So I added 2 in here, description, I added 2 in here. Then I have my call to action, whether it's learn more and shop now or get offer, whatever you want to do. Make sure your UTM tags are there and all that good stuff. So once you do all that, you're going to start running your creative ads, right? And you got to give time for Facebook to optimize. Again, this goes back to how much money you're spending. So let's say if you're spending $25 a day, I wouldn't touch it for at least 7 weeks. So how do you figure out which ones are the ones that are working and which ones are the ones that are not working? So what we do is we're going to close this right here. And then at the ad level, you're going to go down to breakdown right here. And then when you scroll down here, you're going to see breakdown by dynamic creative element. And here it lets you break down the ad based on image, video, or slideshow, website URL, text, if you're using different, you know, URLs, where if you're sending traffic to two different pages, text, headline, description, call to action. So let's say I wanna see which creative is working best for me. So I'll click right here on image, video, or slideshow. It's gonna break it down for me. And now we can see all the data, right? So at a glance, right away, based on this data, I have three different creatives that are tied, three different products. These are all different products, but that tells me that these three products are gonna be the best seller starting out on a brand new Facebook ad account, right? If it's a new Facebook ad account. If it's not a brand new Facebook ad account, then this tells me that these are the products that I should be concentrating on scaling. So what I should be doing here is doubling down a new creative for it so I can scale the account. So you can look at the cost per result, you know, based on the piece or whatever it is that you're selling. You know, you gotta figure out what your CPA is, if it's a good CPA or not. How much money have they spent? Have they spent an equally amount of money, right? If you look at the data here, this one has only spent $100, but it brought in three sales, but this has a lower price point, so that makes sense. So we can say that I let it run long enough to give me a true test of what creative works best based on these two right here that have the same price point, and they spend pretty much the same, $245 and $244, and this app the same amount of sales. So what this tells me here is that it's time to scale these products, but not only that, is my creative working? How's my click-through rate? It's obviously working because it's bringing me sales, but you know, when I'm looking at the click-through rate here of the other creatives, you gotta look at this and it lets you know that you need to work on your creatives because you know, most of them, you know, you have 2.29, a decent CTR, right? It's 1.5 and above. Like this one has a 1.38, but it still brought in sales, which is crazy to me. So that's the actual creative side of things. That's the video or the images, but let's see the other things. Which one's my copy that worked the best? We gotta figure that out. So I go back to breakdown, then I go to dynamic creative element, and let's see which one is the best copy, which copy performed the best. So that's gonna be my second one here. Now I know that this is my winning copy for the whole ad set, all right? So now I'm taking notes of this. I'm taking notes of my best creatives, right? My best copy. And I want to scale using the data that I'm getting back. Well, what I'm going to check next is which headline performed the best. So I go back here and I go to my headline and let's see which headline where I did the best. So it's this one by far, double the amount of results. Okay, so now I know my headline. So what is next? Did we use the description? I can't remember, but let's check which description did the best. So we go once again in here, creative element, description. And yeah, I did use description. So one by far kicked all the others out of the water. So we got that description. That's the winner. So now the most important, the call to action. People argue this one all the time. Learn more or shop now at the top of the funnel. Well, let's figure that out. Let's figure out which one does best. So let's pull it up. So let's see, call to action. Boom, shop now by far. It kicked Learn More's ass. Okay, so now I have all that data. You're like, Christian, okay, now I have all the data. How am I supposed to scale this? Well, now that we know which ones are the winners, we're gonna create a separate campaign and we're gonna start scaling this with the exact combination that wins, okay? The exact combination that wins, the top image or video, the top copy, the top description, the top call to action, and we're just gonna create a new campaign. And that campaign doesn't need to be a dynamic creative campaign because we already got proof of what works and what doesn't. What we're looking to do at this point is to scale the winning creative along with the winning copy and call to action. So what we do is we go back to our campaign level, hit create, right? And we can either, we're gonna scale what we call vertically, right? And once we scale vertically, we can go horizontally. Vertically meaning is you create new ad sets to scale up. And then horizontally is like, if you're getting results, you bumped a budget up by like 15 or 20% every like 48 hours or so, because Facebook can be very touchy. So you go to conversions right here, hit continue, right? And it's gonna create that new campaign. And basically all you gotta make sure here is that you do not choose creative, dynamic creative. So you set the same interest to start with that worked before in the dynamic creative. And by the way, if your dynamic creative is working, you do not touch it, you let it run. You're just starting a new campaign with what you know it's winning. So you don't choose dynamic creative. We're gonna do ad set budget optimization. And then at the ad level, you're just going to load up your winning image, video, or, you know, whichever one was the best. And then your primary copy, your call to action, all that good stuff. So make sure you put everything up. Make sure everything's off when it comes to dynamic. You launch that, okay? Once you launch that, it should work based on the interest that you were using for the previous campaign. Once that happens, we got to keep scaling, right? So it's up to you what you want to do. You want to go up vertically or you want to go horizontally? I personally like to go vertically first and then horizontal. So what I do is I duplicate the ad set that's winning. I choose another audience. I let it run for a few days, see how it does. If it's a winner, I keep it going. Then I duplicate again and then test another audience. If you want to play it safe, all you have to do is crank up that budget by 15% or 20% max every 24 to 48 hours. And that's how you can keep it going with that winning combination. Guys, if you like that video, make sure to check out the links in the description below. Help support the channel. And if you want to keep learning about Facebook ads and digital marketing in general, check out one of the videos right above me. And I will see you guys in the next video.